Hello everyone, in the previous video lecture we have seen the magnetic field intensity and magnetic flux density parameters. In today's video lecture we will discuss about how to solve numericals which are based on DH bar, that is magnetic field intensity parameter. Okay, so let us start with the first question. A differential current element with I is equal to 4 ampere and DL is equal to 10⁻³ meter is located at point 2, 0, 0. Find the magnetic field intensity due to this current element at the point 0, 1, 1. Okay. So here basically there are three steps. The first step is we have to calculate first the product of I into DL bar. Then second step is to draw vector R bar joining the two points, because here two points are given, that is 2, 0, 0 and 0, 1, 1. And third step is to use Biot-Savart's law to find out magnetic field intensity. Okay, so here first of all we have to draw one diagram, that is figure P 5.2.1. here we can see the point 2, 0, 0 is there. This is DL bar, that is differential length, and the second point P, that is reference point, is there having coordinates 0, 1, 1. This is point P. Okay, then after that this is the one vector which is drawn from point 2, 0, 0 to point P. Why we have to take here direction towards the point P? Because in this question they ask calculate the magnetic field intensity at a point 2, 0, 0 due to the current element at this point 0, 1, 1. Okay, so that's why we have to take the direction of this R bar towards point P, that is this DL bar, that is this is nothing but our starting point and P is the ending bar, and we know that how to calculate vector ending point minus starting point. Okay, so here we have to find the magnetic field intensity due to point 2, 0, 0. Okay, so first of all here calculate the value of I, that is given in problem, which is equal to 4 ampere, and DL bar is equal to 10⁻³ meter. Okay, this is DL bar. Then we have to multiply this I into DL bar, then we'll get 4 × 10⁻³ AX bar is equal to 0.004 AX bar. So see here, why we are going to take here value with respect to AX bar? Because we know that in the given location, given point is given in terms of X, Y, Z, and here Y and Z both parameters are 0, 0, so that's why we have to take here with respect to X axis, which is equal to AX bar. Then second step is the point at which we have to calculate the magnetic field intensity. This is 0, 1, 1 as shown in this figure. So here one vector is formed from point 2, 0, 0 to point 0, 1, 1. So here we can easily find out the value of this R, that is a distance between these two points, which can be calculated using the vector concept, that is ending point minus starting point. So here we know that the ending points are 0, 1, 1 and the starting point is 2, 0, 0. So we can directly put here values. R bar is equal to 0, this is 0, 1, 1. And the starting point is -2, -0, and -0. Okay, we have to take here with respect to X, Y and Z axis, which is equal to AX bar, AY bar and AZ bar. Then here we get the value of R bar is equal to 0, -2, -2 AX bar plus 1, -0, 1 AY bar plus 1, -0, 1 AZ bar. So we can easily calculate here the mod value also, that is mod of R is equal to under root of minus 2 square is equal to plus 4 plus square of 1 is equal to 1 plus square of 1 is equal to 1. So in root we'll get value root 6. Okay, so in similar way here we can find out the unit vector also, that is AR bar. So the value of AR bar is equal to R bar upon mod of R. The value of R bar is calculated, that is minus 2 AX bar plus AY bar plus AZ bar divided by root 6. This is the value of mod R, that is equal to root 6. Okay, so here in first step we have to calculate first the product of this I into DL bar. So we have calculated this. Then in second step we have to here draw one vector which is used to join these two point, and after that we have to calculate here the unit vector, that is AR bar. For that we can calculate here first R bar value and after that mod of R value. Then after that we will proceed for the third step, that is Biot-Savart law to find out the magnetic field intensity. So we know the formula for that. The formula is given, that is a DH bar is equal to IDL cross AR bar upon 4 pi R square. So here see, here the cross term is there, means what, we have to take here the cross product of these two vectors. So here let us see how to calculate the cross product of two unit vectors. So for that we have to use this diagram. Okay, so here the cross product of two similar unit vector is always zero, means what, here the cross product of AX cap cross AX cap is always zero. In similar way we can write AY cap cross AY cap is equal to zero, and again we can write here AZ cap cross AZ cap is equal to 0. Okay, so here if we are going to take here the cross product of two similar vector, that is cross product of AZ bar with AZ bar is always 0. Okay, but here if you want to take here cross product of two dissimilar unit vector, then consider this arrangement of unit vectors shown in this figure. The cross product of these two dissimilar unit vector is the third unit vector. Means what? Here, if you want to take the cross product of AX bar and AY bar, then the third unit vector is AZ bar. So the answer will be the third vector, that is AZ bar. Okay. So if we are moving in the direction of this arrow is in clockwise direction. And if you want to take here cross product of the terms with respect to this arrow, then the answer is positive, and if you are moving in opposite direction then the answer is negative. Okay, means what, consider one example. In this case if you want to take here the cross product of AX into AY bar, then the direction is similar with respect to this clockwise direction, hence the answer will be the third vector, that is AZ bar. Okay, this is your answer. But in second case, if you want to take here the cross product of AX bar cross AZ bar, then we can see here the AX bar is here and the AZ bar term is here. Means what, we have to take direction like this, means this is the clockwise direction and this is anti-clockwise direction, means here we are moving in opposite direction. So that's why we here the answer will be the cross product of AX bar cross AZ bar is equal to minus of AY cap is there. Why we are going to take here minus sign, because we are going here in opposite direction. Okay, in similar way if you want to take here again cross product of AX AY bar into AZ bar, then here the direction is same and the unit vector will be the positive AX bar. Okay, so in this way we can calculate here the cross product. Then let us see the equation number 4, that is Biot-Savart law. We have to put here all these values in this equation number 4. We know the value of I into dl bar, that is 0.04 ax bar and the dl bar. Then second is to the value of ar bar. So here the value of ar bar is minus 2x bar plus ay bar plus az bar upon root 6. So we can directly put here value of ar bar divided by 4 pi r square. The value of mod r is given, that is equal to root 6 bracket square. Okay. Then after that, we can here easily calculate the cross product of these terms. The cross product of here ax into ax bar is always 0 because the cross product of same unit vector is 0. Then second is cross product of ax bar cross ay bar, means this is ax and ay bar. So the third remaining vector is here az bar. So we can write here az bar. So this is xy, this is az bar. Then plus cross product of ax bar cross az bar, that is x and z. So we have to take here minus of ay bar. This is minus of ay bar. Okay. So here we have to take the cross product of these all terms and directly put in this equation. So we'll get value dh bar is equal to 2.16 into 10 raised to minus 5 az bar minus, because this x and x becomes 0, this x and y becomes az bar term, and this x ax bar into az bar is equal to minus of ay bar. So it will become dh bar is equal to 2.16 into 10 raised to minus 5 in bracket az bar minus ay bar ampere per meter, because we know that the unit of this dh bar is ampere per meter. Okay, so in this way we can calculate the value of this dh bar. Let us see second problem. Find incremental field dh bar at point p2 caused by source at point p1 of idl bar is equal to 2 pi in bracket 0.6 ax bar minus 0.8 ay bar micro ampere meter. The coordinates of points are p1 4, minus 2, 3 and p2 1, 3, 2. So here in previous example we have seen that here the value of I and dl is given, separately given, but in this case the product of idl is given, that is 2 pi in bracket 0.6 ax bar minus 0.8 ay bar. Okay, so here we can directly use formula for Biot-Savart law, that is dh bar is equal to idl cross ar bar upon 4 pi r square. So here we can see, first of all we have to calculate here the product of idl bar, which is already given in question. Then second step is to calculate the unit vector, that is ar bar. And third step is we have to calculate here the final value of dh bar. Okay, so here let us first calculate the unit vector, that is ar bar. And how to calculate it? We can calculate this value of ar bar using given conditions. In this question they ask calculate the magnetic field intensity at a point p1 due to point p2. Means what here? This is our p1 point and this is p2. So here we have to calculate the magnetic field intensity at this point due to point p1. Hence the arrow is towards the point p. Okay, this is our vector, which is starting from this point p1 and end at the point p2. Then here we can easily calculate the unit vector. So here R12 bar is a vector which is from P1 to point P2. The value of P2 is given and the value of P1 is also given, means their coordinates are given. So here directly use coordinates r12 bar is equal to ending point is 1, 3, 2 minus starting points is 4, -2, 3. So we'll get r12 bar is equal to 1 - 4 ax bar plus y coordinates 3 - -2 becomes 3 + 2 ay bar plus 2 - 3 az bar. Then it is 1 - 4 is equal to -3 ax bar plus 5 ay bar minus 1 az bar. This is the value of r12 bar. Then in next case we can calculate the mod value, which is equal to under root of -3 square plus 5 square plus -1 square is equal to √35. This is the value of mod r. So here we'll get value of this r also and the value of ar12 bar also, and ideal bar is already given. So we can directly put all these values in this formula. So we'll get ar12 bar is equal to r12 bar upon r12, that is -3 ax bar plus 5 ay bar minus az bar upon √35. Then final dh bar is equal to 2π × 10⁻⁶ in bracket 0.6 ax bar minus 0.8 ay bar. This is the value of ideal bar, which is given in this question. So this is ideal bar value. Then into ar bar, this is the value of ar bar, that is unit vector value, and after that divided by denominator is 4πr². The value of r is √35, so it will become √35² is equal to simply 4πr². This is the value of 4πr². Then after that again we have to apply here the cross product values. That is, for this we have to again draw one circle which is having clockwise direction. Here ax, ay and az, all parameters are there. Then here first of all we can calculate here the cross product of ax bar into ax bar. So we know that the cross product of same unit vector is 0. So this will give 0 answer. Then cross product of ay bar cross ay bar. Again this is same, which is equal to 0 value. Then cross product of this ax into az. This is x and this is z. Means what? Here we have to change the direction of this circle. That is, the answer will be the third unit vector having minus sign is there. So we can write here ax bar cross az bar is equal to minus of ay bar. Then the cross product of x and y, this is x and this is y, so here we can take positive az bar. Then cross product of this y and z is nothing but positive ax bar, so this is positive x bar. And then finally cross product of ay bar into ax bar is equal to minus of az bar. Okay, because here again direction is changing. Okay, so here we'll get answer dh bar is equal to 1.93 ax bar plus 1.45 ay bar plus 1.45 az bar nano ampere per meter. This is our final answer, that is dh bar. Okay, so this is all about our today's session. I hope you will like and enjoy. We will stop here with motivational quote. Today's motivational quote for you is, the best project you will ever work on is you. Thank you for watching my videos. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.